This is the men's 50-meter breaststroke final.
The final, the last individual final of the first day here in Glasgow at the European Short Course Swimming Championships. Can Italy make it? He is not the favorite to take it. Or can Ilya Szymanović underline his favorite role, because he finished second at last year's Short Course World Championships. Great lineup. Skuzoli, Kaminga, Morozov, Szymanović in the middle lanes. John Peter Stevens, who had the best start of all, up in lane number one. Kaminga way behind in four. Probably it is Morozov who's first at the turn. Now it's time for Kaminga to close the gap, because it's still Morozov in the lead. Morozov in the lead in five, and Morozov is going to take this one. A new European record. Emre Sacchi second, Skuzoli and Kaminga tied for bronze. What a swim by Vladimir Morozov. The old European record of Fabio Skuzoli falls by more than 1/10 of a second. Huge European record taking the 50-meter breaststroke. Sacchi second, beating Skuzoli and Kaminga by 2/100 of a second. Szymanović also under 26 seconds.
Finaliste, a cominciare dalla Germania che si sta per avvicinare alla corsia numero 8, sarà la prima in basso.
Due prime frazioni con la coppiata dorso Rana, ieri Morozov ha fatto il numero con il record europeo, Kamenieva è una garanzia sul silvero finale. Diciamo che la preservazione del Delfino è perché forse non hanno piena fiducia in questa ragazza.
Cioè in Arina Surkova, ma tutto da calcolare a breve. Dall'alto al basso, allora ricomponiamo la vasca per nazionali. Finlandia, Francia, Bielorussia, Russia, Olanda, Danimarca, Gran Bretagna e Germania. Si comincia con il dorso, rispettivamente affidato a Laukkanen, Manodou, Staselovic, Kolesnikov, Toussaint, Risgard, Davis e Braunschweig. Ultima gara di questa seconda giornata, ultime medaglie in palio, staffetta 4x50 mista all'europeo di Corta qui al Tolcross Aquatic Center di Glasgow, con la Russia che proverà a scappare, che prova a scappare fin da subito, trova una resistenza incredibile in Florent Manodou, Climent Kolesnikov, un Kolesnikov che poi si lascia andare, va al cambio, reattività pazzesca al blocchetto di partenza da parte di Vladimir Morozov.
Beh, 22-67, una bella inquadratura dell'obiettivo da parte dei russi, che sparano via le loro due grandissime frazioni subito, e qua devono avere un bel margine, e ce l'hanno, nonostante un Szymanović super competitivo che va alla caccia di Morozov.
Russia che porta in scia Bielorussia e Francia, adesso tocca a Arina Surkova per quello che riguarda la nazionale che conduce le danze con il Delfino. Per la Bielorussia Anastasia Skurdai, per la Francia Melanie Henick, gasatissima dal successo di poco fa ma anche affaticata, è una Arina Surkova che sta resistendo alla grande però al tentativo di recupero da parte di Bielorussia e Francia. Ultima frazione per la Russia al comando, tocca a Maria Kamenieva che prende un cambio rischiosissimo a 0.09, e c'è una Olanda che dopo la frazione di Jari Verlinden prova a giocarsela con Femke Heemskerk in ultima frazione. Olanda che ha recuperato fino alla seconda posizione, prova ad andare all'attacco, a dare il tutto per tutto. La Heemskerk difficilmente c'è spazio, nonostante un recupero mostruoso vince la Russia, poi l'Olanda per il secondo gradino del podio, la Danimarca. Russia che fa 1.36.22 e guarda un po' che luce si accende.
È quella luce che piace moltissimo, no? La luce che corrisponde al record del mondo.
Esatto, 1.36 e 22 archiviato l'1.36 e 40 degli Stati Uniti, realizzato il 13 di dicembre dello scorso anno durante il mondiale di corsa in Cina ad Hangzhou.
Sì, non male, 22.67, 25.40, 24.94 per la Surkova, chiude in 23.21 per la Kamenieva. Un quartetto notevolissimo, soprattutto trainato da una potenza maschile iniziale di grandissimo livello e poi abbinato comunque a una compattezza dietro notevole. L'intervista di turno.
Intervista di turno con Kolesnikov, che è attrezzato per benino, a tutto quello che può essere appeso lui ce l'ha. La collanina al collo, gli occhialini e la cuffia infilati nel costume. Qui al Toycross Aquatic Center di Glasgow e di essere campione.
E dall'alto la potenza assoluta invece del francese, che è rientrato alle gare di nuoto nell'estate passata, non ha volutamente gareggiato al campionato del mondo, ma insomma il livello è stato riacquisito in brevissimo, a dimostrazione di una qualità atletica piuttosto unica.
Due vasche che se ne andranno tutte in apnea, dall'alto al basso Timmers, Miresti, Jurasek, Morozov, Lobanovski, Manodou, Bocchia, Bilis, finale europea dei 50 stile libero. Una freccia Morozov, ma una freccia anche Lobanovski, corsia numero 4, corsia numero 5, devastante poi l'azione di Florana. Manadou si mette a martellare l'acqua come un forsennato, primo alla virata dei 25 metri. Gli azzurri provano a recuperare ora con Federico Bocchia, corsia numero 7, Alessandro Miresti, corsia numero 2 per la vittoria, però non c'è niente da fare. Morozov, poi Manadou e Lobanovski, 20 e 40, un tempone quello del russo, che si dimostra in stato di grazia, in condizione eccellente, un 20 e 40 che lo porta ancora una volta ai massimi livelli mondiali per quello che riguarda i crono all time. Miresti sesto, Bocchia settimo, Miresti 21-29, Bocchia 21-35.
Beh, insomma, diciamo che gli italiani il loro tempo l'hanno fatto, peggiorando qualcosina. È vero, però hanno mantenuto uno standard molto alto durante tutti e tre i turni, tra il 21-18 e il 21-5 e il 21-3 della finale, per cui nulla da dire. Il livello di questa finale è stato spavent, 20-40 per Morozov, favoloso nei primi 25 metri, notevole Florent Manadou, dalla virata in poi non è stato così efficace in realtà nella prima vasca.
Rana veloce più stile libero veloce.
Ah no, non ne ricordo.
Esatto, è proprio quello che intendevo.
Forse lui stesso, ma non credo che avesse mai vinto nella rana, è sempre stato competitivo.
Nella stessa edizione sto parlando.
Certo, per cui una bella accoppiata.
Today, that is the men's 4x50 meter freestyle final. Let's meet the finalist teams. With Grinev, Kolesnikov, three new names added to the mix from the morning prelims, absolutely hot favorites to take this title. However, it is a 4x50 meter race, a very swift one. Some 80 seconds of swimming, great splash and dash, and who knows what can happen when it comes to the final swimmers. Morozov up against Scott and Miresti of Italy. So Russia in four, Italy in six, adding Alessandro Miresti into the mix, Great Britain in three, putting Duncan Scott at the very end to swim the anchor leg up against Vladimir Morozov. Will he have a chance by then to catch Morozov? This is the 4x50 meter freestyle final.
Take your marks.
McLeod for Britain, Greenev for Russia, Juracek for Poland, Bokia for Italy. But it is Hungary with Maxim Lobanovsky up in front. Lane number two. Lobanovsky bringing the Hungarian quartet. And 21.12, that is the new Hungarian record. Poland in second, Russia third. Now it is already Russia in the lead with Bekovichev, who had a great swim already in the 100th fly. Bekovichev first. Wow, what a great takeover by the Polish Karol Ostrowski. 0.00, the reaction time. So the Poles can hold on to the Russian. What a surprise that is. So it will be Morozov up against Jakub Kraska and Alessandro Miresi. Morozov taking over in first position and seems to bring it home easily. Poland in second and Italy third. So this is Vladimir Morozov and Russia taking yet another gold medal. Poland finishing second and Italy in bronze medal position, just edging out Great Britain. Duncan Scott with an incredible 20.52 second split, but that was not good enough for a medal for Duncan Scott and Great Britain. So we are still waiting for the results to be official, and now they are. Russia takes yet another gold medal. Poland second, Italy third. And gold medal number two for Vladimir Morozov. Within 30 minutes, he wins the 50-meter breaststroke and then anchors the Russian 4x50-meter. And 2 full seconds faster than the Russians today, 11 years later. But, you know, that was the shiny suit era with Amaury Levaux setting world records in the 50-meter and the 100-meter freestyle. Those times, well, out of reach today still for the best sprinters in the world. But Russia take
Morozov, Grinev, Shukova, Kamaneva, Team Russia! This is the mixed 4x50-meter freestyle relay final.
Once again, the lineup. The favorites, France in 2, Great Britain 3, Russia 4, Poland 5, and Italy in 6. So for Russia, it is going... Juracek for Poland. Bokia for Italy. A lot of pressure on young Maxime Grousset, as the French have Manadou, Enik, and Gostolello after him. Russians with a very strong lineup. And also the home favorites, Scott McLeod and Anna Hopkin and Freya Anderson, to bring it home. Start by Maxime Grousset in two, but Morozov clearly ahead of the pack. Winner of the 53 already at this meet, and Morozov is on fire, and Grinev will be first to start. Morozov at 20.65 leadoff, not bad. Into second position, and it will be Surkova up against Melanie Enig, winner of the... It was. So Melanie Enig up in front right now, ahead of Surkova, and it will come down to Castellello up against Maria Kamenieva. And keep an eye on the British as Anna Hopkin brings the team into second position right now. So Castellello, Kamenieva for gold medal. Freya Anderson comes strong as always. It is Russia up in front, and then France and Great Britain fighting for second, but Russia takes it with a new European record. Brilliant swim by Results are not official yet. Let's see the takeover for France. As of Poland in fourth. The computer says the reaction time of Melanie Enig was 0.99, which is of course not the case, but it would be great to see that takeover between Manadou and Melanie Enig. This is how we stand now. Russia with a new European record, Great Britain second, and France in third position. The technical officials to confirm the result. And now they are confirmed. So Vladimir Morozov wins gold medal number 5. With a new European record time, taking down the mark of the Netherlands, which
a butterfly.
As well for the athletes, and this is the final. And the mix, and I think they will be after this final as well. Nuresi in 3, Morozov, Nuresi 4, Morozov 3, Grinev 5.
Take your marks.
Perfect start by Morozov, winner of the 53 and the 50 breast already, with a huge advantage at the first turn. It is short course world champion 3 years ago, down in lane 6, but Morozov, a class of his own, and the halfway turn, he is under world record pace ahead of Shevtsov and Grisey. Can he hold on to that lead, as Nuresi is very strong in the final meters. Russian, a 45.53. Brilliant swim by Vladimir Morozov. Easily beating the field, beating Miresi and compatriot Grinev. No doubt about that. Of the meet. He went out incredibly fast. The pace of Amory Laveau back in 2008 when he set that world record in a shiny suit. And Vladimir Morozov able to hold on to that lead. He is six-time champion of Glasgow and looking to make it seven later on tonight in the relay. He skipped the 100 IM, in which event he is the world record holder, in order to focus on the 100 free, and that paid off. So Vlad Morozov ahead of Miresi and Grinev, only the first two under 46 seconds. And Duncan Scott finished to the final event of these European Short Course Championships, the men's 4x50 medley. The last final of the meet, nine teams. Germany in the middle, fastest in the morning prelims. But here we do have a clear favorite, and that is Team Russia swimming up in lane two. I would expect the world, the European and championship record holder to be, well, at least 1.5 seconds ahead of the rest of the field, with individual champions Kolesnikov, Morozov and Kostin swimming in the 50 back, 50 breast and 50 fly leg. And Vladislav Grinev it is going to be to finish it off. So Russia up into Germany, Italy and Belarus may be the favorites to take the minor places on the podium. Not counting, of course, any disqualifications. So let the party begin. 4x50 medley relay. Kolesnikov and Russia up in two. Just off the individual 50 back final, they are back. Kolesnikov, Diener. Once again, up against each other with the Russian clearly ahead. Diener in four, looking strong, and for breaststroke, it is going to be Vlad Morozov, a safe takeover, to say at least. It is Russia, Germany, and Belarus. Ilya Shimanovic swimming for Belarus. Expect him to be very fast. And also Scazzoli for Italy, as Morozov is pulling away. Emre Sakci next to him in lane one, also looking very strong for the Turks, individual silver medal winner. And it is Butterfly. And Marius Kusch from Germany had a bad takeover, so the Germans might be disqualified in lane four, even if they finish on the podium. So Kostin for Russia, well ahead of the rest of the field, as Grinev starts. So it is Russia, Germany and Turkey as of now in freestyle. Grinev, and wow, huge splash and dash for second and third, with Italy, Miresi coming very strong. And also for Hungary, Maxim Lobanovsky. And it is going to be Russia ahead of Hungary and Germany finishing third. And right now we have Belarus in fourth, and I think they will move into medal position. Lobanovsky with a 20.27 split. The Hungarians enjoying, Kolesnikov enjoying the party. 22.6, the winning time, which must be a new championship record, by the way, for Kolesnikov. And we are still waiting for confirmation. So it is going to be Russia 1, Hungary 2, and I think Belarus 3. So computer says that three teams were disqualified. And here you have the final results. Team Belarus makes it to the podium. And Hungary officially in second, and Russia officially European champions. So three disqualifications in a single final. And Russia from Hungary, from Belarus. 12 very happy men. and they will be back on the podium. So both Norway and Finland disqualified already at the backstroke leg, which means their backstroke swimmers, Marcus Lee and Nico Mäkelä, must have been too long underwater. So they surfaced after the 15-meter mark, and Kliment Kolesnikov, well, he just swam perfectly. So Kolesnikov, Morozov, Kostin and Greenev.